Here's today's In Touch devotion.
Today's scripture reading begins in verse 15 of Ephesians chapter 1. For this reason, I too, having heard of the faith in the Lord Jesus, which exists among you, and your love for all the saints, do not cease giving thanks for you, while making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to you a spirit of wisdom and of revelation in the knowledge of him. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened, so that you will know what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power toward us who believe. These are in accordance with the working of the strength of his might, which he brought about in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things in subjection under his feet, and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all.
Scripture tells those of us who are believers to pray about everything. But in bringing our petitions, it's also important to maintain a divine perspective. Paul, for example, kept God's character in the forefront of his thinking and aligned his requests with the Lord's desires. In today's passage, the apostle prayed that we would know God in three specific areas. 1. The hope of his calling. Salvation gives us eternal hope, based not on external conditions, but on the promise of eternal life. Since this world will always disappoint us, we must fix our hope completely on the grace to be brought to us at Christ's return, as we read in 1 Peter 1, verse 13. 2. The riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. We have an imperishable, undefiled, unfading inheritance reserved for us in heaven. Nothing this world offers can compare to what we already have waiting for us. And 3. The surpassing greatness of his power for believers. God has not left us to do the best we can. His power is always working to transform us into Christ's image and empower our obedience. So keep praying for your physical and emotional needs, but don't forget to include these spiritual requests as well.